Detecting objects with a Do-more PLC is easy. In this video, we'll use three proximity sensors, an ultrasonic sensor, and three different types of photosensors, diffuse, retroreflective, and through beam, to detect the presence of an object. Here's what it looks like on a test rack. Here are the three inductive proximity sensors, the ultrasonic sensor, and a through beam, diffuse, and retroreflective photo-optic sensors. First, we'll connect the proximity and ultrasonic sensors, and then we'll swap those out with the photosensors. The Do-more has a 4-slot base with an AC power supply, the CPU, and a 16-point discrete input module. Two of the proximity sensors are intentionally MPN, and the other prox and ultrasonic are PMP, just so you can see how to connect the different sensor types to your controller. Since we have both types of sensors, we need to make sure the PLC input module can handle both NPN and PMP. This Do-more input module has two commons. Well, that's perfect, because we can simply connect one common to the positive voltage rail, so the NPN sensors can pull the I/O terminal low when they activate. And we'll connect the other common to the negative rail, so the PMP sensors can pull the I/O pins on the PLC up when they go active. And that's really all you need to remember. When you have an NPN sensor which sinks current, you need an input module that can source the current. And when you have a PMP sensor that sources the current, you need an input module that can sink the current. And since this input module handles both, we're in good shape. Automation Direct sensors have a diagram on the sensor or the wire showing exactly how to wire the sensor. This little box is the sensor's load, which is the PLC. And for this sensor, we see that the PLC provides or sources the current from the positive rail to the input of this sensor. So we know, without even looking at the part number, that this must be an NPN sensor to sink that sourced current to ground. We connect the two NPN sensors to this block of the I/O with the positive common, and we connect the two PMP sensors to this block with the grounded common. Perfect. If we bring up the Do-more Designer software and connect to the PLC, we can instantly see the results in the data view. When I pass a metal object in front of the inductive proximity sensors, we see the result. And when I wave my hand in front of the ultrasonic sensor, we see that result. Easy. Notice that even though the NPN sensors are pulling the input terminal low and the PMPs are pulling it high, none of that matters here. All we see in the data view is if the sensor is active. Once the sensor is properly wired, you don't need to worry about whether the signal's high or low. To use that in your ladder code, you just bring the inputs in as you would any other contact. The optical sensors are exactly the same thing. We have a through beam, diffuse, and retroreflective sensor, but really, all we care about is are they NPN or PMP. The through beam is NPN, and the other two are PMP. So we connect the NPN sensor to the I/O block with the positive common, and the PMP sensors to the I/O block with the negative or grounded common. I replaced the other sensors with these, so when we bring up the data view, we get the exact same result. Mechanical switches can be connected as either syncing or sourcing, it doesn't matter. AC proximity sensors can also be used for syncing or sourcing. Just make sure you have an input card that can handle the AC voltage. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any tech support questions on the forums. Automation Direct staff doesn't monitor the forums on a regular basis.